for the next 4 years, the Democrats are going to choose this. And so we're going to use that information to help her to best choose what the party's going to stand for. I would argue that that platform is a more important thing that happens than choosing presidential candidates. Because the presidential candidate, we already know who they're going to pick, right? She's going to pick who we picked because she doesn't want rioting anymore, right? But we don't know how the party's going to stand on these issues, and standing on these issues is going to matter. Because then that's going to allow them to rally and come together and say, like, we don't like the Affordable Care Act, and we believe that our number one goal is to repeal and replace Obamacare, right? And that would be in the Republican Party platform based on what the delegates to the convention decided. So that helps us to gauge information. Ready? Okay. Caucus. How does a caucus work? So the primary was, what did we say a primary was? An inter-party competition. What kind of competition, though? Like what is it? Is it a talking? Is it a race? Is it a tug-of-war, an arm wrestle?
It is a ballot.
It is an election. It is a ballot. Okay? Your state can also choose to have a caucus. We still have a caucus. It just no longer is fat cats in smoking rooms with whiskey and stuff. Okay? Any person who is a registered voter can participate in a caucus. The most famous caucus is, everybody say it together?
Iowa.
Okay. So we're going to watch a video clip, hopefully, from the 2008 Iowa caucus. This is how Iowa does it. Not every caucus is the same because of... Okay, own it and say it together.
Federalism.
Very good. Okay, but this is the Iowa caucus, and this gives you an idea of how it works. I'm gonna watch a little commercial.
By now, everyone knows that in a presidential year, Iowans cast the first vote.
It looks better on my computer.
But few outside the state have a handle on how this quirky and complicated system works, except our senior political correspondent, Jeff Greenfield, who knows it well and will explain it.
Well, Katie, this campaign night tomorrow will be the first test of the presidential campaign. But what happens here is no delegates are selected to the national conventions. Instead, this is a popularity contest, in effect, and the two parties do it in radically different ways. Both parties hold caucuses in each of Iowa's 1,781 precincts. They might be in a school, a church, a library, even a home. But that's where the similarity ends.
He's going to lead our nation with conservative principles. I'm excited to support him.
The Republican process is simple, as this caucus training video shows. You show up at 7 p.m. Declare you are a registered Republican. If not, you can register right then and there. And after short speeches by candidates' backers...
It's just a blank sheet of paper. You simply write down the name, and that's collected, and you're done.
A secret ballot, a straight-up count. The candidate with the most votes wins. A model of simplicity. But the Democrats, not so much.
The registration line is nearing an end.
Democrats show up at 6:30. The doors close at 7. And then, instead of a secret ballot, caucus goers publicly declare their choices by moving into different corners of the room, into presidential preference groups.
Oh, there's so much enthusiasm out there that it's unbelievable.
As this 2004 caucus in Adair shows, you have to stand up in front of perhaps your boss or spouse and declare your choice. Doesn't that raise the possibility of intimidation?
It is neighbors talking to neighbors about who they are selecting for the nominee. It is free and it is open, and you are there of your own volition.
A head count is taken, and critically, a candidate must achieve a certain level of support, usually 15%, to achieve viability. So if there are 50 people in the room, you must have at least 8 in your corner to be viable. You might think of this as a first step in an elimination round. If your candidate is declared not viable, you can either go home or realign, joining up with a candidate who has survived by moving into another corner of the room.
You know what?
What happens then is something between earnest debate and old-fashioned horse trading, as in 2004 when backers of John Kerry and John Edwards argued and pleaded with backers of Howard Dean to join up with them. Once realignment is done, a final head count is made. And each precinct awards delegates not to the national conventions, but to the Iowa Democratic County conventions. Drake University professor Dennis Goldford does his best to explain.
The number of the people in the preference group
times the number of delegates that precinct sends to the county convention, divided by the total number of caucus participants in that precinct.
Right. What really matters, what everybody wants to remember, of course, is the final statewide percentages for Clinton, Edwards, Obamas, and all the other Democrats.
Meanwhile, Jeff, after all the money, the messages, the media, the endless polls, what do you expect will make a headline out of here?
The unexpected. A measurable winner loss for one of the Democrats, a surge by somebody like John McCain or Fred Thompson, and also the winnowing out. We may see as many as four candidates drop out of this race after Iowa.
All right. We'll talk about it more tomorrow night. Jeff Greenfield, thanks so much.
Okay.
Why is it different? Yeah. Different ideology?
Well, it's different because they get to decide how to do it themselves. So, and that is simply how Iowa Republicans and Iowa Democrats do it. I mean, in Texas, I will tell you that Texas Republicans only use a primary. Texas Democrats use a primary and a caucus. Well, they did it up until 2012, and then in 2016, actually the Democrats didn't do their caucus. So this is a dynamic, ever-changing process. It's what the state party and the state legislature choose to do in any given time. South Carolina, they have a caucus. The Republicans caucus one Saturday, the Democrats caucus the next Saturday. They don't even do it on the same day. It's crazy. Because it is not a constitutional framework, because we have literally can have 100 different systems, because we have 50 states and we have a two-party system, so every state can set it up their way. Uh-huh.
So similar to the open primary and closed primaries, if you go to one caucus, can you go to another one?
No.
The other, okay.
You can only participate in one, just like you can only vote in one primary.
Oh, okay.
Because I cannot vote in the Republican primary and the Democratic primary, so I also can't go to both of their caucuses.
Okay, that makes sense.
Okay? Here's what I think we need to do. I think we need to have one. I think we need to have a primary and have a caucus so we can kind of see, like, what might happen. Okay? Now, in order to do this, I have to pre-make some decisions for you. So what we're going to do is we are going to go based on – it's not actually going to be these people. Okay? Wait, we're going to go – based on the Republican Party, because they had way more candidates. Okay, so this will be more interesting and more fun. I know that some of you are not Republicans. I get it. You're just going to pick somebody. Okay? So what we're going to do, and Wikipedia is not blocked anymore, is it? Y'all can get to it. It's kind of hard to find now, but if we're going to go to the Wikipedia website, okay, I'm going to let you guys do this on your phones, you're going to need to look at the candidates that were running for, hush, I'm not giving you any money. Okay, maybe later. I'm so tired of this. Here we go. Close. Okay. All right. So these are the people that you're going to have an option for. Okay, I'm going to show it to you in just a second. Bless you. If you want to know, I'm going to give you 10 minutes. You can click on their websites. You can look at their positions. You can think about what you know. So we're not going to, this isn't going to be a super educated vote. But just go to Wikipedia, put in Wikipedia 2016 Republican candidates. Okay. Once you decide, you're going to have 10 minutes to vote. We're going to do an actual poll, and I'm going to have you text in your vote, so it will be like a secret ballot. And I'm going to have to open it this way, because it won't open that way. So go to Wikipedia to look at the list of candidates, okay. And then we're going to do the poll at Nearpod. So I'll actually be able to collect, so that's how you're going to cast your vote. And then what we're going to do next class is we're going to caucus with these candidates, and we're going to see what happens to our results. Does the primary and the caucus actually look the same? So here, I just want you to have, I'm going to give you 10 minutes, go to Wikipedia, look at the 2016 candidates, see which Republican you might like. And whenever you're ready, you just go to nearpod.com and enter that code, and then you're going to cast the ballot. Now, I can only put 8 candidates on there, so I picked the 8 that were most popular. So, like, the ones that it says on there that dropped out really quickly, I didn't put their names on there. So I only put 8. Where's Bernie Sanders? On the Wikipedia site? So there you go, Prompt Elizabeth. Shock. But the one I looked at was fine. So you're just going to look at those, and you're going to enter that code, and then you guys are going to vote. And here's what I'll do. I'll put the list of the candidates you're going to have an option for. So I'll write the code up here. So it's TNFQE.
Yeah.